deep lobe parotidectomy is a very complex operation, and for that reason, we've created this animation to simplify and explain the basic principles of this surgery. At the beginning, we're going to make a small incision in front of the ear. Prior to this, we'll place electrodes, which will be depicted by the blue and the red disc that are on the face. These electrodes will monitor the facial nerve function throughout the surgery. A deep lobe parotidectomy has two parts to it. The first part is to actually remove the superficial lobe of the gland. Here you see the magic wand come in and it identifies the main trunk of the facial nerve. We stimulate it to confirm that we've actually identified the main trunk, and then we're going to have to proceed with moving the superficial parotid lobe out of the way and off of the branches of the underlying facial nerve. Once that has been achieved, we will then notice that deep to those branches is where the actual tumor lies. So this is really part one of the surgery, which is to basically perform a superficial parotidectomy. Now, shown in the yellow, we will see the tumor that is actually living below the branches of the facial nerve. And again, in comes the magic wand, which will very elegantly separate the tumor from all of those overlying branches of the facial nerve without injuring or causing damage to any of those branches. Once that has been mobilized, we will eventually tease the tumor in between one or two of the branches of the facial nerve in order to remove it from the patient. Once that has been performed, the surgery is essentially completed. We will then test to ensure that the nerves are still working with a second stimulus. And then we will move to close the wound, leaving a very cosmetic and very small incision that will be imperceptible in a very short period of time. The take-home message is that a deep lobe parotidectomy is a complex operation, but it absolutely can be done safely and without any facial paralysis. If you have any questions about anything you've heard in this animation, do not hesitate to reach out. I'd be happy to go over anything you want in more detail. And I hope this has been helpful to you.